All right, everybody in chat looks excited. Hopefully we are ready. All right, let's do it. Here we are. Ba-bam. Conversation with the one, the only, the GOAT, Champagne Poppy himself, Drake. Thanks for coming through, man. Look, let's get right into it. I know you're a busy guy. I don't want to waste too much time, you know, talking about the rigmarole and everything like that. Would you say that you tell the truth in all your rhymes?
Whatever I'm like saying is like it's like from the heart, my personal story, you know what I mean? The things I'm going through, the things that I went through to get to where I am now, you know. So everything that I speak is like is truth to the facts, because I know what the universe does is it manifests it at a very fast rate. So you got to be careful what you say.
No, that's true, because everything that you say has so much impact. You don't want to, like, you know, hurt anyone's feelings or anything.
Exactly.
Right. That makes sense to me. All right. So, you know, but the thing is, like, what about, like, let's say, for example, like the lesbian line, you know, it's like, are you really a lesbian though? Like, you know, she says she's a lesbian, but me too.
Obviously I'm not a lesbian, but like if that girl's a lesbian, that's kind of sexy for me, you know? So I'm gonna be a lesbian too in the moment. You know what I mean? If you're a lesbian and you sexy, you know, you're a model, you know, I have like a standard, you know? So if you're a lesbian, I don't care, man. Like, let's get it together. It's an OVO thing. You already know.
Okay. All right. I vibe with that. You know, do you think one day that your albums and your profile will be as big as Nav's and you'll be able to like dethrone him as like the king of Canada rap?
Oh yeah. Like, I have a lot of big plans right now. Right now I control the media. I got media ties. You know what I mean? I can make anything go viral in a matter of seconds. I have a lot of viral moments as well that I'm hanging on to right now, spreading them out across like the weeks and stuff. I'm in direct contact with Worldstar. I got my song dropping June 1st, Attack of the Colognes with Perkio, my boy. So yeah, we got a lot of stuff in the works right now. That's just the first song. It's a parody. And then after that, they want an album for me as well. So we're in the works on an album right now. So yeah, there's a lot of big things and a lot of people, like the energy that I get from people when I go out into public is insane. You know what I mean? Like people just like run up to me like, yo, can I get a photo? Can I get a video? You know? So like I already have the energy and the viral, like I already have the aspect where a lot of artists, they lack it. Like how people, they just like run up to you and they fan out and stuff. I already have that now. Like, I have no music released right now. The first song I'm dropping is June 1st, and it's with my boy Perkio, like I said, on Worldstar. That's the first song dropping. We're expected to do millions and millions of views for that, just because of how much media attention that we have on us. So, yeah, for sure. Like, the music, it's gonna blow up, and I'm gonna be my goal for myself is to be traveling the world on tour. You know, go on tour across the whole world before I die. I want to travel every single place in this world.
Well, you know, hopefully we'll be able to help you over here on Twitch and play a little bit of that music on New Music Friday. We have these New Music Friday streams. We'll play the track. We'll play it for everybody.
Yeah, my manager was actually talking to me about that. He wanted you guys to review the Attack of the Colognes on June 1st when it drops on Worldstar, and then the album as well when it drops.
Right. Between me and Worldstar, I think you're probably going to get a good media push out of it.
Yeah, for sure. And especially the academics. Academics has been covering me since day one.
Yeah, Academics is a huge Drake fan.
You know what I mean? The thing about this is I haven't paid a dollar. I paid $0 in marketing. And literally, if you count all the posts that happened to me, over millions of dollars worth of marketing campaigns that have went out that I have paid $0 or I haven't even asked them to post. You know what I mean?
Right.
Now, just recently, like maybe like 2 weeks ago, I've been in contact with a few pages and I tell them, oh, here's something, if you want, you can post this or whatever. But 75% of the time is just them posting, you know what I mean? And that's just been recently.
No, it's the magic of Drake. All right. So I mean, obviously looking forward to new music. What's like your creative process like? Because previously, before I started listening to you or just kind of like hearing about Drake stuff in general, like I didn't really... Like, I wouldn't say I was like really a spiritual person or anything. I didn't really like believe in ghosts or anything. But then I heard like you actually had gotten ghosts to write like on your songs. So like, what's your process for getting in contact with the dead to like write some of the music?
So like, I have a record label. So everything's structured and everything. My manager, he runs that side of the record label. So we're basically signing all the clones right now. Like, I've got 50 Cent clone, I've got DJ Khaled, I've got Lil Baby, I got DaBaby, I've got Nicki Minaj. Anyways, I've got so many clones in a group chat, about 30 different clones. So we're working on signing all the clones. This is the new hip hop history. This shit didn't exist back when Biggie and Tupac were alive. We found the loophole and now we're running with it. So like I said, I got the record label. I've got writers. I've got artists that we've already signed. So everything's in a structured way to produce the music in the most professional way that we can. It's not just sometimes, yeah, I write my own stuff, but also I have very professional writers that work under the label, you know. So everything's like reviewed. Nothing is just put out like this, you know. Everything, it takes time, and we do it in a professional way where the people are going to enjoy the music in a way that it's also benefiting them without them really knowing. Maybe with some frequencies, some healing frequencies that we put in there, or whatever chakras we're working, like we're working through the 10 bodies. We have 10 bodies. You may not see 10 bodies, but you've got 10 bodies within yourself, you know, and you've got chakras and everything. So my goal is just to but to put out very, very well music that's like, it can really impact people, and it can show people like there's like, because music is healing, you know what I mean? It depends what you listen to, but music can do a lot of great things for the mind. And that's something that like I want to make sure that with my music that everything's like proper, you know. So it goes through stages, you know. Like, it's not just, oh, I made this and then I dropped this, you know. I make this and then it's got to go for review to the team, and then many producers review it, put their touches on it, you know what I mean? So everything's in a professional state.
Let me ask you, as you move forward here and you're kind of getting more like attention drawn onto what you do, like, you know, is there kind of any friction or anything, or like drama, like for example this Pusha T guy? Do you think he's going to be giving you any more trouble?
Yeah, like I said, me and Pusha T, we haven't been good for a while. And I don't want to speak too much on that, but all I know is that what he's doing is not trending anymore. That's the old school way of music. What I'm doing is big things, you know what I mean? So he can't even compete to the level that I'm on.
No, I agree. And honestly, it's like, I feel like at this point, you're kind of beyond that. You're above that. That's drama that you don't even need to touch at this point. I mean, honestly, because you've come on here and done me a favor. Listen, I've been listening to this. I mean, you probably don't listen to his music because it's like, it's so old school and it's so irrelevant and so out of touch and everything. But I've been hearing it. And this guy says he's like selling a lot of cocaine. And on your behalf, I'd be willing to like maybe put in a call to like the police or something, because if he's selling even half as much cocaine as he says he is, like he should be like out of here immediately, you know, and then he'll be totally out of your hair. So, and you won't even have to do anything. You won't have to call or
yeah, figure. Like I said, like, I really don't like speak it on drama because then you start to manifest on that stuff.
But right, exactly.
I know where I stand and I know where he stands.
No, I agree. So, you know, have you really like, you know, you're talking about like these friends that you have, you're making all these connections. You were mentioning all those people earlier, 50 Cent, Nicki Minaj, but you didn't mention Kanye. Is there like a connection with Kanye as well that, you know, because people have been talking about how you guys kind of like reforged everything. Is there going to be like a Kanye clone or something in your group?
Yeah, there's definitely a Kanye clone, and yeah. we're in the talks of big things. I can't really release too much because it's on the NDA. But you will start to see it roll out.
Okay. When you're writing a song, just like a creative process question, when you're writing a song, where do your ideas come from?
So, can you say that again?
Where do your ideas come from?
My ideas come from past experiences, present experiences, and future experiences, manifestations. That's where it comes from the heart of things that I've gone through, things that I'm going through, or things that I plan to go through.
Okay.
And then it manifests very fast into reality.
Got it. Why do people say that Kendrick is better than you if he doesn't sell as many records as you? Because you're selling more records, so your music must be better.
Yeah. I'd say because morally, because he's just talented with his vocabulary.
Right.
But he's not near on the record that I'm on, like on track where I'm on. I've got more everything, like views, I've got more records sold, like,
but he's very good with his vocabulary. That's why.
Speaking of views, like the photo on that, did they have to like put you, did they get a crane or like a helicopter to put you onto the tower for
yeah,
the album
so that,
cover?
That was photoshopped.
Oh.
So it looks so real
right.
that it's real, you know.
Like, right. Okay, wow.
Yeah. OVO things, you already know.
I'm embarrassed. Oh, now I'm embarrassed that I asked that. Okay. All right. So I'm thinking of like the recent trajectory of your career and how like you had,
Hold on. There you are. Okay. People keep calling my phone.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
It's all good.
So I'm thinking of like the recent trajectory of your career and how you had like this big blow up in like attention and like everything when there was a point where you were kind of like hiding a child, you know, would you consider like a sequel? Would you consider hiding another child to get more people talking about your music?
No, I'm not. I wasn't even trying to have the first child in the first place.
Right.
That's why I keep that hot sauce around me. And you already know it's an OVO thing.
Got
I'm
it.
Trying to have no more kids.
Enough. But technically, wouldn't you consider Jack Harlow your first child though? Like, or like another, or like a 1.5 or something like that?
From past life, yeah.
Right. Okay. All right. Yeah. No, that makes sense when you kind of frame it that way.
That's why my child looks exactly like him.
Right. Okay. Well, So next question. What would you say would be like a perfect day for you?
A perfect day?
Yeah. A perfect day for Drake.
I wake up. I got food. I got my chef already made my food. You know, I got breakfast ready to go. Then I go hit the gym, and then after. Maybe go play some basketball in the gym, and then after that, just go get some nice fancy dinner. You know, treat myself, hang out with some nice shorties. You know, and that's pretty much it, bro. Like, I'm pretty simple going guy. You know what I mean? I just like the luxury style because I worked hard for it. You know what I mean? So I deserve to have it.
Well, you mentioned shorties there. What would you say for all the women who are in chat? Like, what would you say is describe like the perfect woman? Just so like, you know, people know so that they're
a perfect
if they do fit like the profile, how can they like get on your radar? You know, just to like know if they fit the profile.
Well, yeah. It's like me, I got a type, you know. So if you ain't a supermodel, I ain't fucking with it.
Right.
So like, you got to have a nice butt. Nice pair of tits, you know. Also be genuine as well, you know, with your heart, you know. I gotta feel that connection with me and you, you know what I mean? But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, you, as long as you a supermodel, you bad, and you got a good heart, it's a OVO thing. I'm with you.
Okay. All right, well, there you go. I saw you one time on SNL, and it was very funny. It was pretty good. Have you considered like acting and stuff, or like getting into doing acting?
So like I said, I did acting in the past from Degrassi. That's how I got to where I got to where I am, you know.
Oh my god.
Yeah, like I direct a couple shows.
This is why you research.
But like
I didn't do the research.
Morally, I'm trying to get back into the acting scene shortly at the end of my career.
Right. Yeah, that makes sense.
You know, where I come from is where at the end of the day, that's where I go.
Yeah, no, I get it. All right. You know, a couple more, because again, I know you're busy. I wanted to ask you about like kind of the sentiment in some of your stuff where you talk about like, you know, no new friends. Also on CLB, there were like a lot of
new friends in the industry.
Right. And on CLB,
I have no new friends in the industry. I got to keep a small circle. I got my OVO friends in my circle, you know. I only fuck with a few people. Chubbs, he's my main guy, you know what I mean? It's an OVO thing. And then I have a few others that I've been fucking with for over the years, but I ain't have no new friends in the industry, because when you have new friends in the industry, they gonna fuck you over bad, you know. So you got to keep your circle small.
Okay. All right. No, I get it. But when listening to CLB, it seemed like there were a lot of lonely vibes on that record. You know, like, are you maybe?
Yeah. There's a lot of lonely vibes, because you kind of have like a small circle, and I can't really like open up to too many people, because I don't know, like, they might take advantage of me. So I just got to kind of stay tight with my circle. You know, it is what it is, and it sucks sometimes, because I'd like to meet new friends, but like the position that I'm in, I'm the number one artist in the world. So
I can't really like open up my space too much, or that's how I get taken advantage of, you know?
That's a bit of a strange dynamic because, you know, on a personal, like on an interpersonal level, you have a hard time kind of opening up to people one-on-one, but yet on your records, you're opening up your heart to the world.
Yeah. Cause I want the people to hear like my story, you know? So I have to open up to the world in that kind of aspect where they're not going to be able to screw me over because it's just through music. But if I start opening up to people like that in person, you know, that I'm open to vulnerabilities, which is not good at all. So I can do that with my music because you just listening to it, you can't manipulate me. But if I'm doing that with beside you, you know, you can manipulate me. So I gotta keep it close.
I got it. Of what you know of me, would you say generally that my reviews, my coverage of your work has been too harsh? Do you think I could be maybe more favorable to your work?
Nah, bro, you asking the questions, you know, you trying to get your information. So it's all good. You know, it's an OVO thing. So keep doing what you're doing. You know, I like it when you ask me these questions because they need to be asked. You know, people need to know the information.
Right. Okay. I wanted to ask quickly about YOLO because that was a while ago.
YOLO, you only live once. That's the motto every day when you party, a day.
That's true.
But
again, that was a while ago. And since then, you've become so much more famous and so much richer. Do you think you're at a point of popularity?
Y'all, don't be excited if I'm famous or if you want to be famous. Famous ain't the way to go. You know what I mean? Like, I can't even step out of my house without security following me, you know? So, but like I said, YOLO is basically, I made that song a long time ago. It's just because, like, you only live once. You got to do everything to your best and know that you are like, shit, someone's calling me, my bad.
It's fine. You're Drake, you're a busy guy, so.
Yeah, I got people blowing up my phone all day, all night, you know?
Right, of course. But
back to what I was saying, I made, oh, fuckers, stop fucking calling me.
Well, I just want to know if you've reached a point where you feel like you can maybe live twice, you know, if you're only just planning on still living once.
You can't live twice because God only lets you live once. You got to do what you got to do. So you can get to the place you got to be.
It's a sucky technicality.
If you always think you're going to live twice, you're never going to do your best in the moment, you know, because you're thinking like, oh, I'm coming back. I'm living twice. But you ain't living twice. You're living once.
Okay.
That's where people slack off. They think, oh, I'm going to get another chance. I'm going to get another chance. Nah, this is your chance right now.
Okay. All right. I like the passion. Would you ever, I mean, you're a very charismatic guy. I mean, beyond music, would you ever consider like politics, running for president of Canada or something, or America?
I ain't about that shit.
No. Okay. Yeah.
I try to stay away from that shit. That shit gives me a headache.
It's too much drama. Yeah. You know, closing things out with a serious one. What would you say is your favorite ice cream flavor?
My favorite ice cream flavor? I don't even like ice cream.
Right. I was going to ask you, like, do you guys even eat ice cream in Canada? Isn't it too cold for ice cream in Canada?
A lot of people eat ice cream, but I don't really fuck with it.
Oh, I thought you guys outlawed it up there. But.
Yeah. Right. Me, I don't really fuck with ice cream. I try to keep a slim diet. You know what I mean?
Right.
I got to keep those abs going. It's an OVO thing.
It's an OVO thing. Yeah. Well, listen, it's been amazing having you on.
Yeah, you too, man. I appreciate you asking all the questions, you know.
Yeah.
Make sure everybody checks out my song June 1st dropping on Worldstar. It's a OVO thing, you already know. And make sure you review that shit because that shit's going to blow up. I'm telling you, this is the new hip hop history. Attack of the Clones. We broke the record to the top. I don't give a fuck what nobody says. I'm going with it and we're riding with it. OVO tape. Done now.
I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited. And I hope you're excited too. You look excited. So I'm excited.
I'm fucking excited, bro. We're going to the top. God's plan.
Well, thank you so much, man.
All right, man. Take it easy.
Well, have a good one.